Rebecca.
I'm here.
Are you all right? Hey, you managed to stop the train.
Yes, we managed.
We have to find a way out. The Umbrella Research Center? The first general manager, Dr. James Marcus.
Who on earth are those people?
She's just a rookie, a member of STARS.
What about the male?
I'm unfamiliar with
Attention! Him. Mm-hmm. This is Dr. Marcus. Please be silent as we reflect upon our company motto. Obedience breeds discipline. Discipline breeds unity. Unity breeds power. Power is life.
Who are you?
It was I who scattered the T-virus in the mansion. Needless to say, I contaminated the train, too.
What?
Revenge. On Umbrella. Ago, Dr. Marcus was murdered by Umbrella. You helped them, didn't you?
You stay here.
Yeah.
This way!
Okay.
Thank you. Let's regroup.
Roger.
I'll go alone.
Roger.
Come on.
Okay. You stay here.
Yeah.
Are you all right?
Yes, thank you.
I'll check it out.
Okay.
This way.
Okay.
Thank you.
I'll go check over there.
Yeah.
Follow me.
Okay.
I'm almost there.
Well, I'm glad I could be of service. Time to go inside.
You are wasting your time. I have already claimed this place for myself, which means you are trespassing. And I am very territorial.
Just doesn't make sense. Do you honestly believe this to be the real identity of that crazy young man? Impossible. But if somehow it is true, then Umbrella will be finished.
If the old conspiracy against Dr. Marcus is revealed, Mr. Spencer's career will be over. Not to mention ours, too. So, the time has come at last.
What are you going to do?
I will simply say goodbye to Umbrella. The biological weapon utilizing the T-virus has almost been completed. Our only remaining task is to acquire combat data.
You can't be serious. I refuse to abandon my work. I have finished the research on the T-virus, but I need a little more time to complete the more powerful G-virus.
Do as you wish. I will follow my initial plan and lure the STARS members into the mansion. Their superior combat training should make them perfect test subjects.
Fine. In the meantime, something must be done about that madman. As I recall, URC is equipped with a self-destruct device in the basement. I'll find it, set it off, and annihilate the place to nothing more than a mass of rubble.
Help!
Don't mention it. Just keeping my word. We promised to cooperate with each other. Remember?
This is Rebecca. Over.
Rebecca, this is Enrico. Have you managed to locate Cohen yet? Over. Rebecca, answer me.
No, sir. I have not found him yet. I'll continue to search for him. Over.
Rebecca.
My first mission, and I've already disobeyed orders. So much for my great law enforcement career. Oh well, I probably won't live long enough to worry about it. Billy, I just need to know. I need to know the truth. Did you kill 23 people? I'm not going to judge you. I just want to know the truth.
It was around this time last year. Our unit was ordered to Africa to intervene in a civil war. Our mission was to raid a hideout of some guerrilla forces located deep inside the jungle. But the hideout was far away from our entry point. Died from the heat. Others were killed by the enemy. In the end, only four of us survived. Only there was no guerrilla hideout.
What do you mean?
The idiots in charge had us operating based on wrong information. But we couldn't just go back home empty-handed, oh no. Our leader ordered us to attack an innocent village.
Get rid of them!
Kill them all!
Please, sir! Cease fire immediately!
Shut up! Ugh. Do it!
Do it. Oh.
Did you execute those innocent people?
Forget about it. Doesn't matter anymore. That was then, this is now. Besides, you said you wouldn't judge me.
I'm not judging you, but it does matter. Look, now my people think you killed those MPs in the van, but I don't think you did. It was those zombie dogs, right? When they attacked the van, you were able to escape. Isn't that right?
You don't get it. I've only got two choices left. Either report to the Marines and serve out my sentence, or keep on running for as long as I can. That's all.